Hello. I think I know a lot of you, but I'm Nick, NB, and...
I'm Yona. So, can we sit down, please, so we can start? Yeah. Thank you. So, I'm Yona, I'm from Albania, and together we will talk about the ambassador's budget, but as I mentioned, will not be aimed only to ambassadors, but also to other people that they might need budget for an event. So, how many people are ambassadors here? Okay, and how many people are interested mostly into the budget process, even if they are not ambassadors?
Or who is interested in becoming ambassadors? Yes. You're not an ambassador. You should be one. I will go click the button and make you ambassador. After this talk, I will click the button. I believe you know enough to be an ambassador. Okay. So we got together earlier and came up with some topics we think we should talk about, and then we also hopefully will have plenty of time that people can bring up whatever topic we want to discuss. I don't see this as being us talking at you about stuff. This is meant to be a discussion of what everybody thinks. Hopefully it'll be productive. The first part is what you...
Okay, so the first part is related to ambassador's basic process. So, because lately I have seen people that they are asking, so how is the process? And they are not really sure how to, let's say, request some budget, even if they are ambassadors. Mostly, I don't see anyone, in fact, from APAC, because mostly from them, I had some questions. That's why one of the topics that we thought to cover was this one. So even if you are not an ambassador, it's the same process. So first of all, you need to create a wiki page for your event. So you can include there the name of the event, where it will happen, when, the time, and the date. And also you need to write there what you aim, what you want to achieve with this event. What is the outcome of the event. And also you need to have a clear agenda at the event. So if you are organizing it, for example, what will be the agenda, who will speak, who will be the speakers. And if you will go to another event to speak, what is the topic that you will cover there. So this is for the wiki page, and after creating the wiki page, you can open a ticket on Pajur. So you can request budget, and what you need to write at the ticket. So you can include the wiki page, the link of it, and also you can write one sentence about the event, and again, what is the outcome that you expect from it. And also, an estimation related to the people that will attend the talk or the event that you will organize. And also the amount. So related to the amount, if you are the organizer of the event, what you want to do with this budget? So you want, to buy some snacks for the event, like we do, for example, for the release parties, mostly. Or if you will go to an event, so for example, your travel expenses, accommodation, and how much is the total of it. So having this, two points that I mentioned, after this, your ticket will be during the ambassador's meeting. You need to be there during the meeting, so you can say a few words about it, and the ambassadors can review your ticket, and if they will have any questions, you can respond to them. And after that, you will see if it will be approved or not. Mostly, for example, in India, you need at least 5 votes that can be approved. And related to swag, when you're organizing an event, of course, that you can request even swag. Mostly, for the moment, on the wiki, if you check it, we have written there that only ambassadors can request budget. But what will happen with other people that they are not ambassadors? For the moment, what we have done, for example, we have talked to them and we have said that you can talk with the local ambassador, so he can open the ticket and he can write there, let's say, your address, so the swag can go there. So in this way, we are more confident that this swag will be used for that event, because the ticket is opened by one ambassador that we know. And also, is the same, let's say, even with a budget ticket, even if you are not an ambassador, the process is the same. You need to follow the same steps that I mentioned, but just try to be pretty clear at the steps and mention all the things that you said. So for ambassadors, it can be easy to vote on the ticket. Any questions related to this part that it's not clear, or you want to suggest something we can improve? Please. We just said to him that first of all he could ask one of the ambassadors to request budget, because I mean we need to see, it depends on the cases, because if we see that he has opened a FAST account 1 month before opening this request, how can you know for what he will use this budget or even the swag? That this was the case that you were saying, because we didn't know him at all.
I see the perspective as well, but the guy in the end, he was a victim of it. In
totally agree with you, but I just want to avoid the cases that we don't know pretty well that person, we don't know nothing. Something else that we can add here is the event report. Yes, just a moment. Okay, so without the event report, we cannot know how successful was your event, let's say how many people attended it, or we need to know what opinion you have regarding the event that you did or you attended. And without the event report, especially with the reimbursement, I think, you cannot be reimbursed without having that event report. So, because I see it as a very good way even to measure what happened at your event. So, what we were thinking, I have seen even the comments that you mentioned to do a template for ambassadors, and I think that these very nice to have it, so we can, for example, some questions, we were saying even at the diversity today, so they can, they mention at their event before that they want to write. But on the other one, on the other way, you were saying, there was something there.
Oh, I mentioned how, which has come up before, and I'm not the only one that says this. I don't have a blog. I don't use a blog. I don't particularly want to create a blog just to use like once a year to make an event report. But that brings up like Tomblog. A lot of times we've been publishing event reports on there. That way if people don't desire to have a blog, they can still make an event report. Or what I have done in the past is I write my event report and send it to the mailing. That is still a report, and even though I choose not to have a blog.
I was going to ask on top of that. So, I know some people are very active readers of Fedora Summit, but my opinion on this is that something as important as project name is being shared from the professor with something regarding the ambassador, what was important. Ideally, learning something from an event you're going to and getting feedback. Away and what we share in the community. I am generally opposed
ambassador, or then the mentor will put a ticket in the FAMA track, or not, okay, not track, yeah. And then they will sponsor them into ambassador. I think some of it kind of depends on the mentor and the candidate. If it is someone like Bex was like, hey, I'm not an ambassador. I'm like, why the hell are you not an ambassador? And, okay, I know he knows what he's doing. I know he knows what Fedora is all about. I'm not going to go through a bunch of steps before I approve him because I know he has what it takes.
Standardization, guidelines, or policies. I do agree, like, every lead candidate
went ahead and brought up Matthew's blog post, which kind of goes along with what we were wanting to talk about anyway. So recently they're asked, we're being asked more to talk about what is the impact of the events we're doing, what do we hope to accomplish, and did we do what we said we wanted to do? And Matthew made his blog post a couple weeks ago talking about aligning what we're doing to the objectives and to the three visions. So I just wanted to kind of bring up, what can we do to basically better justify what we're currently doing, and what do we need to change, or maybe what should we try to get more results? I figured a lot of people would have things to say.
Comics,
CI, and the right person for the right event, which will be a change from how at least we currently do stuff, which is based pretty much based on proximity. The West Coast ambassadors do the West Coast events. The East Coast ambassadors do those events because they're there. And we usually have just talked, mainly we talk about Fedora Workstation, which I guess that would line up with one of the additions that is Fedora Workstation. But I guess what, from reading the Matthew's blog post, it would be more of, yeah, we could talk about Fedora Workstation, but we need to say what we hope to accomplish. Am I understanding that correctly, Brian?
I'd say yes, but it's not just the topic about which we talk, it is the audience between which we talk.
Yes.
So similarly this morning in the diversity conversation, we were talking about, you know, which solution to underrepresented population and ensure that they understand that we are a welcoming and inviting community. We also wish to contact members of that community to
available. We just need to ask for it and say what we are hoping to do, not just we're out of money, give us more.
Right, yes. The other thing on the plan is maybe if there are some other companies that can at least start to share, you know, research and other communications with each of those companies.
Yeah.
And in the past, you put a pocket in an awesome tool, but it's primarily designed to make sure it's small and integrated. It's not going to be
Hotkit is part of Fedora Service, isn't it?
Yeah, but
well, the objectives or the additions.
Let's not dial this from 0 to 11, please. Let's not go from talking about sentiment to llama mode to refusing to think about anything that isn't one of these things. Like, remember, this is a sliding scale.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll pick on one of them. I'll pick on one of them. But if you were to say to me, there is no banging community that you've traditionally spoken to and that happened to meet these other things, yeah, as long as you're not spending like $50,000 on software, you know, that we're buying cupcakes. Oh, well, yeah, who actually cares? I mean, like, nothing personal, cupcakes is not money, so yeah, do that thing.
Yeah.
You know, Lisa, we're going to go to it every year, right? And that's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like yourself, we were discussing that last year because that was right around the time of the budget changes and stuff. And Jeremy, the guy that runs Southeast Linux, he told us, he's like, he very much wants to see us return. He would even go so far as to not charge us the $500 boot fee if we didn't have budget to pay for it, because that's the door there.
When it comes to the website, it's called the cross country, and other countries, you know, $250 to get in, and the flyers, these people are pulling the bus to talk, and the air, so I'm telling $200 a night.
people are very violently in favor of their preferred or of their preferred desktop. And if we don't give it to them, then
Yeah.
USB keys are comparable to